que hacer diferente desde el campamento hasta el día que subas al cuadrilátero para precisamente que ya no sean tan cerradas y que...
No, entrenar al 100% como siempre lo he hecho, no hay ningún secreto. Entrenar, estar física y mentalmente muy bien, eso me va a llevar a la victoria. Y obviamente en este momento me siento más maduro, con más confianza, me siento en mi momento, me siento más fuerte. Creo que esa es la diferencia.
¿Ayuda el que haya sido para arriba en pesos, mientras que él haya tenido 4 peleas contra rivales que quizá no eran elite, por llamarlo de alguna manera?
Pues me ayuda en mi experiencia, en tener más confianza también en cuadrilátero, en este peso, porque si recuerdan, cuando peleé la primera vez en 160 libras fue con él, entonces obviamente te da mucha confianza.
So two questions there. So first, two of the first fights were very close fights. What have you had to do differently in terms of your training camp to get it right, to make sure it's not as close as those first two fights were? And Sal's answer was, just the same as always, really, just training 100% so that I'm ready. There's no secret to this. You know, I have to do everything I can and be ready physically and mentally to go and get the victory. But now I'd say I'm more mature, I've got that confidence to go into it, so that's what's different about things now. And the second question was, has it helped you the fact that you've gone up in weight? Because during that time, Gennady Golovkin has been fighting fighters that we couldn't consider to be elite fighters, Sal's answer was. I think it's kind of that experience. I think if you think about the first time that I fought at 160, it was against him, so it was going up. So I'd say I have more kind of experience now and more confidence in what I'm doing.
En ese sentido, Saúl, sobre todo en la segunda, él dijo, voy a tirar más golpes al cuerpo, terminó tirando 2 menos. Uh-huh. Y básicamente, para los que crean que es válido que él ganó, si la ganó es solo por el jab, lo superaste ampliamente en golpes de poder y en golpes al cuerpo. Es algo que a lo mejor van a cuidar, que no le vas a estar dando puntos por el jab en esta pelea.
Yo voy a hacer mi pelea, él va a tratar de hacer lo que sea para hacer sus puntos, y claro que va a hacer puntos, no es boxeo. Pero al final de cuentas, yo voy a hacer lo que tenga que hacer para ganar la pelea.
So the question was, you know, in the first fight, there was a lot of talk about body shots and things. You can talk about the points that you won, and perhaps you won quite a lot of points by just using that jab. Are you going to have to kind of avoid him winning those easy points by using his jab? And Sal's answer was, you know, and I'm just going to do my fight. I'm going to fight in the way that I know. He's obviously going to try and win his points by using whatever means necessary, but that's boxing. I just need to focus on what I'm doing.
Canelo, do you like when your opponent talks trash, like Billy Joel?
Yeah, okay. I kind of like.
Why?
I kind of like because I train more hard and I go into the fight with, I feel like more danger.
What round is the knockout coming if I wanted to bet?
I don't know, but my goal is to end the fight before the 12 rounds.
Just to ask you, follow up on your question about, or your answer about risk before, there was a lot of people that were urging you to fight Triple G before you first fought him. I think when you fought Amir Khan and maybe even Cotto, right? When did you know the time was right? How did you know it? Did Eddie or somebody else advise you, hey, okay, now you can take a risk? And
no, look, I have I need to accomplish things in 154 and then go in 160. That's that thing.
Question for Eddie Reynoso.